Now we'll move to question number 4, where again we have to simplify. The first question is a to the power 0, b to the power minus 2, whole raised to the power 5 divided by 2 into a to the power minus 1. Now a to the power 0, anything raised to the power 0 becomes 1, which we know that we have written here, into, we know according to the law that in this cases the exponents get multiplied. So b minus 2 or minus the exponent minus 2 of b gets multiplied with 5, we get minus 10, and in the denominator we have 2 a to the power minus 1. Now let us keep the number section separate, 1 by 2, and the variable section, both have negative exponents. So if we reciprocate them, the exponents become positive and our work is done. So 1 by 2 upon reciprocating, we get a by b to the power 10. Next question is 4 a to the power minus 3 b to the power 0 divided by 2 a square b to the power minus 1. We can easily reduce this 4 and 2, we get 2 out of it. Now see here, a and a same basis, b and b same basis. So we know how to divide the exponential form if the bases are same. We write a minus 3 minus 2, and in case of b, we write the base and we subtract the exponents. So what we get is 2 a minus 3 minus 2 gives us minus 5 into b 0 minus 1 or 0 which becomes 0 minus minus 1 which becomes 0 plus 1, or it gives us only b. So the answer is 2 a to the power minus 5 into b. Then we come to question number 4, which is pretty simple sum, but I've still shown you how the working how it works. 2 to the power minus 4 whole raised to the power 3, 2 to the power 3 whole raised to the power minus 4. Notice that here both the exponents are same, it's just that their placement is different. So if I follow the rule, I get t to the power minus 4 into 3. In the denominator also, I get t to the power 3 into minus 4. Upon doing it, we get t to the power minus 12 by t to the power minus 12, which gives us 1. The next question is question number 6. 3x to the power minus 2 divided by 2y to the power minus 1 whole raised to the power minus 2. Now we can do it in two different ways. Here I have shown you one way, that let us first consider this exponent. It is negative. So what we have to do is the base gets reciprocated. Here in the next step I have done the same thing. I have reciprocated the base. The denominator becomes numerator and the numerator becomes denominator. And as a result, our exponent becomes positive. Now we focus on the base. So 2, which is raised to the power 2, can be written as 4. 3, which is raised to the power 2, can be written as 9. Now, if we notice at y to the power minus 1 by x to the power minus 2, and we work on it, minus 1 into 2, we get minus 2. Minus 2 into 2, we get minus 4. Notice that here both the numerator and the denominator's exponent is raised to the power 2. That's why I am multiplying 2 with both of these exponents. Now upon doing that, I still have negative exponents which we do not want to keep in our answer. So what we do is we try to make them positive. And to make them positive, we reciprocate them. We get x to the power 4 by y square. Okay, so that's how we get our answer.